from the Cleveland, from the Akron Zoo, I should say, joining us this morning with a couple of her friends. And you've become attached to one of them.
I love Stace.
Yeah,
they're
he's
really
attached
cool.
to you, Stace.
Literally.
And both of these girls are Dumeril's ground boas, which are snakes that are found in Madagascar. Brooke happens to be a little bit close to 4 years old here. She'll be turning 4 here later this summer. And Pickpocket is actually going on 20. So
how did you get the name Pickpocket?
It actually, I was doing a program with her when we first acquired her at Akron Zoo, and we hadn't actually named her yet, and it was a program for a group of Girl Scouts. And I happened to mention that she didn't have a name, and one of the girls was like, well, her tail has been in your pocket the whole program. You should call her Pickpocket.
Oh, that's a
and
name.
It stuck, and that has been her name ever
now,
since.
How do you know it's a female?
That is a test that our veterinarian can do, probing, and so we you can tell female from male. But other than that, there's no external differences,
mm-hmm.
right? Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Wow. So let's talk about what they eat.
Well, obviously, Wayne snakes
awesome.
Are carnivores. Yeah.
yeah.
And these guys are going to feed primarily on some smaller rodents. I know Wayne is a huge snake fan.
No, you know what? So I've made peace with snakes.
That's really good. I mean, snakes are great animals.
Yeah. They feel so
cool. Certainly
I like
ones
when
that
when they wrap themselves around me.
Yeah, yeah. Well, and a lot of that is because you're warm, so that feels good. But even though a lot of people don't like snakes, they are so essential to all of our different habitats because they do help to keep the rodent population in check.
Yeah.
And otherwise, a lot of us would be eating corn on the cob this summer. That was really pretty nasty.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah.
right.
Stuff.
Tell us what else. So kids can get really up close and personal. Your zoo is fantastic.
Yeah, actually,
you got these shows coming up.
Yeah. So people that come to the show, we actually will call volunteers up during the show to help hold Pickpocket and our other big snake, obviously with some staff assistance. Another opportunity to get up close and personal is in our Trainer for a Day program. So that's for kids 8 and up, and so they can actually come and spend the day with myself and the other trainer in the show and get a good all-day behind-the-scenes look at how things run in the zoo and about animal training and doing shows at the zoo. So we'll have to nickname her Pickpocket, maybe.
Yeah,
Pickpocket.
Right.
Now, you were saying she's 8?
She's actually almost 4 years old.
4 years old.
Yeah.
And she'll get that big.
Yes, in theory. So these guys are about 8 feet.
It's amazing how they wrap
themselves
around.
So they are the same kind.
Yes, they are the same kind of snake.
Wow.
Just obviously, several years apart in age.
Several years.
All right, do you want us to help? You want to bring her over here?
Yeah, we could do like a whole group effort here.
We got a lot going on here.
She says, don't let your faces get too close
together. I got this one here.
They're so heavy.
Believe it or not, she actually only weighs about 30 pounds, but it is pure muscle.
Yeah, it is muscle.
They're extremely strong.
To feel their muscles.
Yeah, you can feel
that.
She's moving there. It's really cool.
Oh, my God.
That's all muscle.
That's
all muscle there.
Oh, she's slithering back to me.
Yeah, she is. She wants to go back to you.
I have a new assessment. I like that. That's good stuff.
That's right.
Thank you so much for coming.
Sure.
She's comfortable. She's just like she's in a tree.
Yeah.
Do you know what the funny thing is? It's like a lot of times children, my son thought he was afraid of snakes when he was smaller.
Yeah.
And then you get up close and touch them and learn about them, and they're just absolutely fascinating.
That's really what we strive for at the zoo, too. Both in the show and education programs that we do. is getting people to take a second look at those animals that they might have some issues with. Snakes, spiders, all that kind of good stuff. So, the cute and furry ones obviously can draw people in. But, there's a whole realm of animals out there that are not so cute and furry, but are just as important for people to learn about.
How many animals do you guys have at the zoo?
Over 700 animals at Akron Zoo. Grizzly Ridge was our latest expansion. Obviously, the big grizzly bears are there. We also
That's a great area, too.
It is. And we just kind of expanded on that. We have a new nature play area that we just opened up. So it's all natural, and it's designed for kids to get into activities that relate to the movement of primates. So testing their rope climbing abilities and things like that.
If you've never been, this is the time to visit the Akron Zoo. Definitely. Wayne has a new accessory.
That's right. Yeah, we're bonding.
She's found a home. She's perfectly comfortable right there.
I like it. That looks good.
It does look good.
You can get exercise
fresh out of
her mover. She's comfortable. I don't want to mess around.
She's shy.
Wayne, I think you found your pet.
I think so.
She found you.
Yes, she did.
She loves you.
They always say the pet chooses the person.
Can I take her home?
There you go.
The zoo might frown on that from my own.
We're missing one of our residents.
I know.
Well, you have a bracelet and I have a belt.
Yes, you do.
There you go.
Yes, you do. Thank you for stopping by.
Thank you so much for having us.
Thank you, Deborah. Great job.
Thanks. Awesome.